go wildcatting.
My God.
Come on, guys, come on. Oh, hey, watch here.
I don't think I've ever wildcatted a well before.
Come on. Go.
The ranch owner can be kind of hostile.
They're going to respect me. They're going to respect my property, or they can get the f*** off.
Well, that's not a tool pusher's trailer.
Archer, that hey, the one who's got the shooting range and owns all the guns?
Yeah, that's the one.
My God.
Hurry the f*** up!
You guys are speeding down my road.
I'm in the path, boys!
Don't f*** with me. I'm not playing. It's what I say goes. The reason for the gun is to keep stupid rednecks like you from f***ing up my
Jerry told me, man, we're gonna be wildcatting on this well, man. I don't think I've ever wildcatted a well before.
Wildcatting means like you're just buying property and just drilling to see what you get.
Who's that?
There ain't no tool pusher's truck.
What are they doing?
The f is that, man? Who's that?
Whoa, no, that's not a tool pusher's truck.
Whoa.
It's a chick.
That's a girl.
No, that's a woman. That ain't no girl. What is she doing, fool?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, that's a woman with that.
Shotgun,
dude. Oh.
Hi. What's your name?
I'm Brandon Watson, Cheston.
I'm Peggy Hauser. I own this land. So y'all headed to work?
Yes, ma'am. We're about 10, 15 minutes late.
Is that why you were driving 80 miles an hour?
Yes, ma'am.
On my road?
Okay.
You guys are speeding down my road. I have cattle out here. I have cattle guards that are expensive to replace. The reason for the gun is to keep stupid rednecks like you from f***ing up my
This section of land, we might find some oil. It's the riskiest well I've personally seen.
Can you unroll your map here and kind of show these guys where that prospect is?
Oil tycoon Autry Stevens has gathered his top brass to stake out the biggest gamble of his career. It's a plan that will change everything.
It is a pretty risky venture here. And we're tired of getting just these 50 or 100 barrel a day wells. We need some 300 barrel a day wells. We're going to go wildcatting.
My God.
Try to get some big oil for a change.
Wildcatting is the riskiest move in the oil business. It means drilling deep into the unknown. If it hits, Autry could strike it big. But there's a reason few dare to walk this road.
It's kind of risky. It's got about a 10 to 20% chance of success. You got several million dollars invested in the acreage, and we need several million more to drill a deep well.
I just want you to be aware of what could happen to us.
Okay. We're drilling right on a fault that I'm going to have a real hard time keeping the hole straight as the formation is dipping.
Autry, you know this was a very risky well. It's actually probably the riskiest one you've drilled since I've been here. But if we don't hit, it's going to be a huge loss for you.
I know there's a substantial risk. But we need to hit this one. My banker says we've got to hit this one.
Well, I hope you're right.
If Autry's gamble is gonna pay, he'll have to count on his roughnecks to make it happen. 2 miles to the east, roughneck Josh Castile is on a mission to pick up a wildcat of his own.
Brandon calls me up, you know, told me he was in jail, and I was just like, what? Got in a little bit of trouble. Going to pick his ass up, keep him out of trouble, man. He's got to quit that shit, dude. You think he'd learn.
Come on, man. You want to stay another night?
Margo, get the out of here.
Brandon Watson's got a reputation for hard work.
Brandon! Brandon!
What's up?
And a short fuse.
Want to talk? You can get your ass full.
The only thing standing between his talent on the rig
beat around a bush
and a promotion to driller is himself.
That sucked. How was it? It was bad, dude. You're in there, it was about 20, 25, 30 people. Everything's concrete. The is just exposed, you know?
Oh, my stinks. Gosh, man.
It's nasty, and everybody's drunk, dude. I got tickets with the municipal court, county court. It's stressful, dude. I want to go to work, you know? I don't want to be home for another day, you know? I can't afford it, bro.
Oh, man.
A mile up the road. Headed towards his evening shift is Cheston McElhaney.
Things are a lot easier now that I'm not a worm. I didn't know anything. I was 0 days in the oil field. Now I've got my feet underneath me a little better, so.
For months, Cheston has tried to win the respect of his fellow roughnecks.
Respect to me is everything, and those guys never really gave that to me. And you know, now that I know a little more in the oil field, I don't have to take as much.
But in the oil fields, respect is something that's earned in inches, not miles.
Oh, this is my mountain, king of the hill.
Let's go to work.
Here we go.
Every oil rig has a strict hierarchy. And like it or not, Cheston's spot on Lee Tong is at the bottom.
I worked Lee Tong last year. You know, I like to do something different, and me doing something different is the other tong. I'm taking the other tongs.
After a year of being low man on the totem pole, Cheston's decided if someone's not giving him the job he wants, he'll just take it. Only problem is the spot he's gunning for belongs to Brandon.
That's your tongue, bro.
Huh?
My tongue.
Nah, bro.
There they are.
Now, do I wrap them?
I'm throwing.
I wrap them, dude. That's how I wrap them. Don't f*** me, dude. Come on, dude.
I'm throwing.
I wrap them.
Hey!
Come on.
I'm throwing them, bro.
Just go get that. You're a f***ing lead tongue, bro.
Hey!
Why you gonna get mad, bro?
But the trouble on the rig is just beginning. Back downtown, Autry's adding fuel to the fire.
It's located on a ranch where the ranch owner can be kind of hostile.
Autry's plan will mean putting the roughnecks into the crosshairs of an angry landowner.
Autry, is that Peggy one that's got the shooting range and owns all the guns?
Yeah, that's the one.
They've got the right to drill on the land, but the road there is owned by Peggy Hauser.
I've heard a lot of stories, Doctor.
One of those pistol-packing mamas, huh?
I'll guarantee it.
Well, Walter, I'm glad that you're going out there.
She's a lady. You don't know if you carry roses or bullets.
Well, I'd suggest you carry both, Walter.
I hope you're right.
Yeah.
Back at the rig.
What the f-
The Roughnecks are still ticked off at Justin's rookie outburst.
Where the f*** is he going, you know what I mean? If he's going to get pissed, he's in the wrong f***ing work. He needs to go be a clown or go work at a bank or something. I don't know who Chester think he is today. The way I say it right now is I say screw whatever Chester wants. Chester ain't going to get his way out here.
At the first sign of trouble, tool pusher Freddie Moore is on the case.
We got a little problem here. Chester, I told him he's a lead tong hand. He thinks he's everything else out here but a lead tong hand.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'll fix all this right now.
Cutting to the chase is Freddie's specialty. Woo! And with word out there's an open supervisor's job, Freddie is making sure his name's at the top of the list.
To help him, so I help him.
No. What is your spot out here?
Them lead dogs.
That's what your job is.
That's what I signed up for.
I don't give a f- what you signed up for. Ain't this your boss?
That's fine.
Okay? You are the lead dog hand. That's just the way that's going to work.
Chestnut there, he thinks that, you know, he's Tom Cruise of the f***ing oil field. He ain't. He ain't nobody to me. He's no better than any hand that's busted his ass on this rig.
I don't want to work this crew anymore. I'm done, dude. Dude, I don't want to be designated lead tong. It ain't fun, dude. I'll go home. I told you I wasn't working lead tong.
If Chestnuts wants to move up, he better smarten up and better pick his feet up, or he ain't never going to get off them lead tongs.
After a sleepless night worrying about the Wildcat well,
I think this well has more than enough risk for me.
Autry and Champ head out to set the plan in motion and check on Peggy's land.
We know it's less than 50% chance. We've probably got a 10% chance, maybe 25% of hitting. It's just exciting to have the possibility of striking a well that might make $500,000 a month. Man, we're really getting out in the countryside.
Well, you got the roads located?
Yeah, location gonna be out there about 200 yards, Autry, and we're just gonna build a road and come in on the south corner of it.
Is this the rancher's house up here, Walter?
Yes, sir, that's Peggy's house right there, sir. Right there where she can see us.
Ooh, that's not good news.
It's too close for comfort. Too close for comfort.
Well, we probably ought to pay her a courtesy call and make arrangements to be out here and settle any damages.
All right, sir. We'll get started. I just wanted your approval.
Come here, champ.
Coming up, the Roughnecks rule the rig.
You let it go, motherfucker! I'm tired of hearing you!
But she calls the shots.
You don't take a gun down on location, do you?
Yes, I do.
What the f*** is this?
And...
Hey, watch him!
Take...
Oil man Autry Stevens is taking his biggest gamble yet.
We're gonna go wildcatting.
If we don't hit, I don't know how many millions, but it's going to be a huge loss for you.
But before he can start to drill, Big Dog needs permission from the woman who owns the road to the Wildcat property.
What do you mean?
Hello. I've been expecting you guys.
Oh.
Okay, so this is everything you guys need to start drilling?
Yes, you know, if you'll just sign that, that'll get us started.
I just don't want any dumbass roughnecks tearing up my land. Tearing up my roads, tearing up my cattle guards, hitting any of my cattle, throwing trash out. Which one of you guys do I talk to if they do start screwing up like that?
Oh, when you want to raise hell, talk to him.
Well, you know I can raise hell.
I know.
I've heard that.
We don't want any problems, and if we start having one, if you let us know instantly, we will take care of it right instantly.
Okay.
Right away.
You know, in the past, you know, everybody always promises they're going to take care of the lease road, and but I've had them tearing up roads, tearing up cattle guards.
It happens. In some cases, cattle guards do get damaged, but we will fix them. You got our word on that.
Okay, we'll see.
You don't take a gun down on location, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, I think we got a policy, no guns on our locations.
But it's my road, my land. And on my property, I can have the gun, right?
A signed lease is the green light Big Dog needs to start drilling. Peggy's given Big Dog 6 weeks to drill on her land. They were hoping for 3 months.
You ready to make some money?
We're ready. We're always ready.
If she's not happy, at any moment, she can pull the lease and bring drilling to a halt. On the outskirts of Midland, Terry Tank Hannon is heading out to the oil field for a shot at redemption.
I'm really nervous about going back and get my job. You know, they're going to give me. I really, really hope for a second chance.
6 months ago, Tank failed a random drug test.
One of them's out of here.
That cost him his job.
The tank will be back. That's for sure. Until they put me in the ground, I'm going to keep trying.
After losing my job at Big Dog, I hit rock bottom. And I think you got to hit rock bottom to finally pull yourself up off the mat.
After attending rehab and passing a new drug test, Tank is hoping for a second chance.
Hey, other side.
It's a new beginning for me. And there's a lot riding on this.
Well, I'll be
ready.
What are you doing,
Tank? How you doing, sir? It's been a long time.
Yeah, sure has. What's going on?
Yeah, I need a job back.
Well, you got to leave all the rest of the alone, your extracurricular activities. I don't give a what you do, but it's going to come back to bite you in the ass.
I'm cleaned up now. I got my paperwork if you need it.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Well, you know the last time when you was out here, you had a real problem, and that sent you down the road kicking rocks.
Uh-huh.
Are you sure you pissed in that cup?
I did.
No
it was witnessed.
Well, I'll be damned.
Uh-huh.
I'm proud of you.
Thanks, boss.
Well, we're going to get you on Oscar's crew, on Daylight Crew.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Oscar's going to be a different cat to work for. Straight up driller. You don't do your job, he's gonna be in your ass.
Some of the things I'm a little rusty at, but I'm gonna dive in head first.
Okay. I'm gonna keep my eye on you.
Okay.
And if I catch you f***ing up, I'm telling you, cat, I'm gonna be dead in that ass.
You got it. Thanks for the opportunity, boss.
All right.
I won't let you down.
We'll see.
All right, boss.
All right.
Okay.
Bye.
With the supervisor job opening up, Freddie's not taking a chance on anything or anyone.
Yeah. I'm back, man. It's redemption, baby.
The good news is Tank's got his shot at redemption.
Feels good. Feels real good.
The bad news, he's got to work for daylight driller Oscar Barreras. Oscar's one of the toughest drillers in West Texas, and he's looking for a promotion to tool pusher.
I don't take no slackers. I want people to work hard and work their asses off for me. But if you can't, man, we'll have to let you go. I ain't going to put up with no
last year.
I understand. Thanks for the opportunity, right, man. Thank you.
It's been half a year since Tank set foot on the rig floor.
Let's get this motherfucker going.
Oscar is counting on him to work hard and work safe.
You know, people don't understand that we could die any day on these rigs, you know. But just like I told my hands, you know, they need to watch their asses, you know, take care of each other, you know.
44-year-old Tank still got the want to, but getting his rhythm back may take some time.
Come on, guys, come on! Hey, turn the gun!
Some point, I'm just gonna keep busting my ass.
Watch out! Watch them tunnels, they'll come and hit you. Give me another one.
Go ahead!
Ow. Hey, watch him!
Coming up.
Stand here talking to me about
this. You're the one brought it up!
About to say, you're
the one
to hear it all. I'm
trying to hear your own business.
Beautiful.
It's Tank's first day on the job in 6 months.
Got it! Hey, watch him! Hey, pull him real quick! What the...
Distracted and still rusty, Tank throws the 450-pound tongs right into Josh's skull.
All right, man, he touch in the air. Damn, man.
Tank, man. Act like you ain't ever done this before, dude. We do this every day. What the are you doing, man?
Damn, dude. Oh, man, let's
get this connection done.
Get him in! Come on, that's how you got to hit him in and go. That's an easy way to go to the hospital, you know. That could have cut him open, you know. We're working with nothing but iron out here, so, you know, any little thing will hurt you quick.
Ain't no going home just from getting hit in the head with a tongs. I've been knocked out twice on the rig, man. Got back up and had to go back to trip and fight. Ears are ringing.
It hurts, man. But...
You're good, bro.
Skirt.
That's why I'm hard-headed, you know what I mean? A little bit of miscommunication.
My bad, man.
You're all right, bro.
Love you, dude. Sorry. I feel like
it. It's already a major strike against Tank. And Oscar may not wait around for strike three.
I get bothered because it pisses me off, you know, because I'm responsible for every person on this rig. They learn from this, hopefully, you know, they won't do that again. They do, that's when I start chewing more ass.
Josh is like a, basically he's like a son to me. I'll be on my toes, man. I really didn't mean to do that.
If things aren't already bad enough, they're about to get worse.
Oscar!
Freddy's just gotten word that the rig is slated to move to the Wildcat Well.
We're gonna have a long day. It's gonna be a long, treacherous rig move. It's gonna probably be a two-day rig move. We're gonna drill a well over outside of Midland that they ain't ever drilled that deep over a long way. It's gonna be like a Wildcat Well that we're gonna drill over there. It's gonna be around 12,400 foot. Gonna test everybody on this rig, okay?
As far as going Wildcat, man, they said this place has never been drilled at this depth, so I'm worried about it. I mean, you never know what to expect out here in the oil field.
As the rig gets set to move,
no one's gonna disrespect this land.
Peggy Hauser is surveying the land the Roughnecks will soon take over.
You know, I've lived in Midland my whole life. I've lived here on this ranch since I was a little girl. This is all I have left of my family. This is all my father left me. They may pay me to drill on my land, but they're going to take care of it. They're going to respect me. They're going to respect my property, or they can get the f*** off. There's one thing for sure. If they're going to be out here drilling on my land, I will be watching them. They can count on that.
Hard labor.
It's moving day on Rig 28.
Time to go to work now.
The Roughnecks only have until sundown tomorrow to move 200 tons of steel 50 miles west to Peggy's land. The move will take every bit of manpower available.
I thought you was smarter than that.
And the man in charge is 66-year-old tool pusher Jerry Chansey. 5 months ago, a freak accident left him blind in one eye. But with rumors flying, either he or Freddie could get a promotion.
We're TJ! TJ!
He's out to prove he's the man for the job.
Take it to
Promotions in the oil field are hard won and are only given to the toughest roughnecks in the business. For a tool pusher, that means riding his roughnecks to get the job done right.
Hey, you pussy! Damn, you don't listen.
He may be blind in one eye, but Jerry can spot a worm from a mile away.
My grandma's in a nursing home. She's faster than you are. Get over here and start on these ditches. Quit around.
After hearing about Cheston's attempted coup...
Go get that!
Jerry isn't taking any flack.
It's a slow burn, mother.
With no one else to lean on, Cheston turns to the one person he thinks will care.
It's right there, that behind right there. That way, look, right there, boom. You go talk to him right now.
You act like I'm scared. I'm scared of this.
I know, but you've been telling me, bro. Talk to him, you're gonna talk to him, because I'm tired of hearing about that. Well, it's over with. Work, just work, dude.
I am working, man.
Standing here talking to me about
it. You're the one that brought it up.
You brought it up.
Just walked up to you.
No, I'm just telling you. Go talk to him. That way I ain't got to hear it all.
Go talk to him. That way I ain't got to hear it all.
Let it go.
The intense pressure to move Rig 28 to Peggy's land has all the roughnecks on edge, and Cheston's gone complaining to the wrong guy.
You let it go!
What the in my face, dude?
I'm tired of hearing you!
I didn't say to you! I'm tired of hearing business!
Go over. I can work with them, I'm just tired of hearing the sound. You don't want to brought it up, so
you did, dude.
I got split up. It's cool, we can hang out.
It's a bad day right here, man. We got friends wanting to fight friends, man.
Day one on Peggy's land, and everyone's under the gun to rig up and get to drilling.
A wildcat well, you know, if we don't hit something, I mean, it could mean a possibility that, I mean, we may lose our job.
For the last 2 days, tool pusher Jerry hasn't eased off the roughnecks for a second.
Get it straight!
Coming down!
Now he's got to get the most important piece built,
sure,
the BOP, or blowout preventer.
Get up!
The blowout preventer is the last line of defense on a rig. If the BOP fails, the results can be tragic, like the recent disaster in the Gulf of Mexico.
this way. Y'all get everything hooked up so we can undo that rotary table that was tightening.
10 hours under the sun, and the rig is almost rebuilt.
Y'all tie all of these here, get them out of the way.
The last step is to piece together the rig floor. Jerry's assigned driller James to head up the effort.
Here. Hold that off.
Yeah, if you move at a faster pace, things, you know, can happen. You can get hurt a lot easier.
Come on, Johnny, pick it up!
Without warning, the chain holding the half-ton plate snaps and nearly crushes James.
James and I were holding it, trying to keep it steady, pushing it off to the side, getting the floor plate out of the way, and the chain we had put in it, I don't know, I guess it wasn't the right size for the lifting iron, and then it came out and fell. That's steel, that stuff's unforgiving, so he got lucky.
Put the chain back in it. Just go around it right there, pick it up, get it out, boy.
It's the kind of mistake that could cost a life or someone's job.
We just couldn't agree on it. I mean, Jerry wanted to do it one way. I'm telling him to get a bigger chain, and you see what happened. I mean, who knows what would have done? We got the floor wide open, so it probably would have killed me there.
With the last piece of the well in place, Jerry finally leaves the rig floor.
You never know, though. Anything go wrong out here.
Coming up.
She's a lady, you don't know if you carry roses or bullets. Well, I'd suggest you carry both, Walter.
This is my You guys will slow down, or I'm going to start blowing your tires out.
Are you serious?
Dead serious.
After a 50-mile, two-day-long move to Peggy's Land...
Let's get this hole punched.
Rig 28 is finally spudding in and ready to start drilling.
Let's get fired up on this Wildcat well.
You gotta spin the hole for real luck.
But the pressure on Rig 28 is just starting to build. Autry is sending his right-hand man out to the rig to light a fire under his tool pushers.
Well, I don't know that Freddy's ever drilled a Wildcat, so I'm going to fix drive out there today and visit with him about it and make sure he's aware of all the hazards.
Freddy, I was wondering if you ever drilled a Wildcat before.
Well, it's been many years since I drilled one, back in the 80s.
Well, you realize that Autry has spent a lot of money buying this acreage, so it's going to be a hell of a deal. Gonna be really a big play if we hit.
Yes, sir.
You know, we don't have any bottom hole pressures. We don't know what it's gonna take to hold it. And you're almost guaranteed H2S. And you realize the hazards and dangers of H2S gas. So,
yes, sir.
We have no idea how much, but there will be H2S gas. So we're gonna have to stay on top of it from top to bottom.
Well, I'll get her drilled for you.
Okay.
I can't guarantee what's down there, but I can get her drilled for you.
In Odessa.
How's the married life?
I couldn't ask for a better life, Justin.
Justin's kicking back with an old friend. Gerald Williams is a legend in the West Texas oil fields.
Will you marry me?
But a few months ago, after a late night out celebrating his new marriage...
Is it shot time?
Right.
He showed up late for work.
Fire him, you only let him work for what?
Okay,
bye.
Get
you
going. And it cost him his job.
He knows better. The man knows better.
Now he's scraping by any way he can.
So what's been up, son?
We're wildcatting.
So wildcatting?
Wildcatting.
No.
Never really done it before. But what about you? You never done any wildcatting?
Yeah, I didn't know there was a lot of that left anymore. Those were my glory days, doing the wildcats, you know, going into the unknown. Yeah, I like wildcatting. That's my game right there.
I know Rosie don't want it, but you could easily come out there and get a spot, you know? I mean, you're a way better driller than a lot of them dudes out there.
You know, don't get me wrong, I love my wife, but I love that oil field, too. And, but...
I'd love to see you back out there.
You know, I certainly miss drilling. It's a way of life for me. It's been my life for 35 years.
You need to come out.
You think?
I think it'd be good to have you out there, man. It'd definitely put a smile back on my face and make it fun again.
Maybe I need to go talk to Mr. Freddy.
Yeah.
I might slip out there the next day or two and talk to him and see what me and him can work out. Because I'm sure he could use some good help if he's out there wildcatting.
If it happens, let's cheers before.
It's kind of like we've always said in oil fields, huh? Good drillers go in harder and come out faster.
Same. Believe it.
Coming up.
Well, hello, Mr. Freddy.
Oh, Gerald. How you doing, sir?
The legend goes for broke once again.
Yeah, I was just wondering if you had any driller spots out here, Freddy.
And the Roughnecks have landed.
Oh, that's not a tool pusher's trailer.
In hostile territory. In Odessa, Texas.
I thought I'd go out blowing Freddy's air and see exactly what was going on.
Word's out that Big Dog Drilling has gone wildcatting, and legendary driller Gerald Williams is fired up.
The last time I left Big Dog, it wasn't good. We'll just have to see how it works out. Drilling's in my blood. It's what I've always done. It's what I like to do.
But to get the job, you'll have to pay a visit to tool pusher Freddie Moore.
Well, hello, Mr. Freddie.
Oh, Gerald.
How are you, sir?
What are you doing out in these parts?
Oh, just piddle farting around.
Well, it's something other than just piddle farting around.
Looks like you lost a little weight there, huh? No, I just thought I'd come out here and see what was going on. I was looking to get back in the field. Thought I'd come see if you needed any drillers.
Well, last year, Gerald, things didn't work out too well.
No.
You know?
I partied a lot last year.
Well. And who's the hell to say that you ain't slowed down?
I have slowed down a lot. Got married. And...
I don't know what your extracurricular activities consist of now. But,
I was just wondering if you had any driller spots out here, Freddie.
Well, you know, right now we're just all filled up. Hell, I've got everybody I need out here right now.
That's good. But glad you lost a little weight there. It's easier on that heart that way. But it's good to see you, Fred.
Well, it's good seeing you.
And I'll get out of here and let you go back to work, son.
All right.
Come see us once in a while. Thank you, sir.
Take care of yourself.
You too, sir. Well, you know, that didn't go as planned.
I'd rather not jump off on that bandwagon. I'd just rather work with what I got right now. You know. Especially after the stunt that he pulled last year.
Well, I got some other ideas to explore, so it'll work out somewhere.
Who would have ever thought? The legend looking for a job.
After a long day of drilling,
how's the welding going for y'all? Leave it tired.
The right. Boys of Rig 28 head to a local bar to blow off some steam.
We had all kinds of go wrong.
Take the drive.
I don't even remember what I was working the out of y'all.
Story is, you got banged in the back of the head with some tongue.
Dude, I got my ass lit up, bro. I can't.
Who's tongue?
Tank.
Tank?
Tank. Caught me behind the ear. I didn't know what the hit me, dude.
Bro, Tank.
I got hit by a tank. That's what it felt like.
Tank, he's a strong, big. I've seen him in the gym, bro. Monster.
But gym ain't the same as roughnecking. You know it ain't.
I know that.
You gotta have endurance. Like,
yeah.
Roughnecking endurance.
Josh, I don't think I have it.
Hey.
I don't think you do either.
So what's up, man? What you think about this wildcatting world?
I don't like it at all, bro. They're gambling with my job, you know? I don't mind taking my money out of my pocket and putting it on the table, but
you hit that wrist, man, it's
double.
This is the roughnecking and wildcatting.
The next morning.
I don't think I've ever wildcatted a well before.
Right?
Cheston and Brandon are running late for their shift.
People buy these leases and this property and just drill on it just to see what they can come up with.
So it's a gamble, you can lose all your money?
Yeah. Who's that?
I don't know.
There ain't no tool pushers, Trent. What are they doing?
Who's that, man? Who's that?
Whoa, no, that's not a tool pushers, Trent.
Whoa.
It's a chick.
That's a girl.
No, that's a woman. That ain't no girl. What is she doing, fool?
Yeah.
Dude, that's a woman with a
shotgun, dude.
Whoa.
Hi. You guys in a hurry?
Yes.
Where are you going?
I'm going to work.
You work on this rig?
Yes, ma'am.
What's your name?
I'm Brandon Watson, Cheston.
Who's your pusher?
Freddie Moore.
I'm Peggy Hauser. I own this land. So y'all headed to work?
Yes, ma'am. We're about 10, 15 minutes late.
Is that why you were driving 80 miles an hour?
Yes, ma'am.
On my road?
Good.
You guys are speeding down my road. I have cattle out here. I have cattle guards that are expensive to replace. The reason for the gun is to keep stupid rednecks like you from f***ing up my f***. This is my f***. You guys will slow down or I'm going to start blowing your tires out. There's a 10-mile-an-hour speed limit on this lease road. The next time you fly down this road, I'm blowing your tires out.
Are you serious?
Dead serious. Are we clear?
Yes, ma'am.
We can fight or throw rocks all day long, but in the end, it's what I say goes.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll be watching you guys.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't with me. I'm not playing. Thank you. It was nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you, too,
Peggy. Thank you, Miss.
Sorry. I'm sorry, Peggy.
This is gonna suck. It's real.